Whenever a story takes place in a nebulous high-tech future, there always seems to be some sort of augmented reality. Maybe it's an engineer inspecting a floating 3D model of a high-tech gadget, or a team of scientists working away at a projection of a computer screen, or even full-sized or miniature or gigantic holograms of people. So, to propel SciShow into this future, this episode has two hosts. Kinda. Now, this digital version of Michael is current hologram technology, basically recording a 3D video of someone or something and dropping it into a new environment. In this case, the environment is the SciShow Studio. This Michael Aranda hologram is a 3D video of him that we can watch using Microsoft's HoloLens device. It's basically a self-contained, super powerful head-mounted computer that projects holographic images onto transparent lenses in front of your eyes so you see them like they are in the room with you. It's not quite the same as a standalone holographic image, like R2-D2's recording of Princess Leia, but it is a 3D video that you can watch from all different angles. It's known as a free-viewpoint video. And it took a lot of advanced technology and creative thinking to make it, so Microsoft gave us a sneak peek at everything that goes into creating and viewing one of their holograms. To make a 3D video, you need to know a lot about the scene you're trying to capture. Specifically, you need to know what it looks like from every angle and how everything is arranged in three-dimensional space. Individual video cameras can capture a lot of visual information, like colors and textures, but they don't tell you much about depth, the 3D shape of a thing, and how it's moving and changing in space. Traditional motion capture is what's happening in behind-the-scenes footage from movies, where actors are wearing those special suits or have weird dots on their faces. That equipment helps special cameras track every precise movement that they make. But motion capture alone can't give you the other kinds of visual information, like color and texture. So the HoloLens team created a special studio setup with 3D capture technology to record both types of information at once, the appearance of the performer as well as how things are arranged and moving in 3D space. Using their setup, they can create a 3D video based on the exact performance, and here is how the magic happens. There's a circular green screen stage with a performance space a couple of meters in diameter. It's surrounded by around 100 synchronized video cameras pretty much on all sides. By combining images from all these cameras, computers can figure out where something is in 3D space and what it looks like, and then use all that data to generate a 3D holographic image. Half of the cameras are RGB cameras, which form an image based on visible light. Their main job is to capture accurate colors and general outlines of the performer. The other half are IR cameras, which capture the infrared light reflected from the objects in the scene to map out depth. These cameras help generate most of the 3D figure and capture the texture of things like faces, fabrics, and other props. The team calibrates all of these cameras, and then it's time to record things like actors or animals or whatever you want to digitize to help tell a story. The cameras then send all of their synchronized footage, which is a lot of raw video data, to be processed into one compact 3D video file. The central computer does a few things. It turns the footage from all the different camera perspectives into a single 3D figure. But that 3D model includes so much detail that something like a mobile device wouldn't be powerful enough to play it back. So their computer software simplifies the model, keeping a lot of the detail in important places like hands and faces, but taking away details where you might pay less attention. Then it adds colors to the image. Finally, it produces a single compact 3D video file that's small and simple enough to be played back on a computer or streamed over Wi-Fi to something like the HoloLens. And there you have it, your very own hologram that can be put into movies or even your own environment to create an augmented reality. For now, there's a limit to how much detail this technology can capture. For one thing, it's hard to generate good holograms of translucent material like water or glass, or finely detailed fabric like lace. In those cases, capturing depth becomes much more complicated. And you do need a fancy studio, lots of computing power, and advanced technology to create these holograms in the first place. But the hope is that eventually it won't be too hard to make your own holograms. Maybe someday it'll even be as simple as picking up a camera and making a YouTube video.
A big thanks to Microsoft and Actiongram for letting us play around in their studio and for turning me into a hologram. And thank you for watching this episode of SciShow, which was brought to you by our patrons on Patreon. If you'd like to help support the show, you can go to patreon.com/scishow. And don't forget to go to youtube.com/scishow and subscribe.
I'm a paper printer, only instead of creating a two-dimensional image, it's three. And instead of laying down layers of ink, it squirts out whatever material you want. Plastic, metal...